I am very excited. You know, I haven't actually seen it yet. There have been a lot of screenings that have been about, but I haven't been in the country or I've been abroad. And it's just amazing to be able to get the chance to come and see it. So I'm having a good time here. Neverland looks amazing, you know. So we're all very pleased at the way this on its own has turned out. I can't wait to see what the movie looks like.
Can you tell us a little bit about your character and where he fits into things?
Okay. I play Bishop. He is the first mate of Blackbeard, who is the number one bad guy in the movie. Blackbeard is the captain of the main ship. I am the captain, and I am Blackbeard's first mate, and the captain of the Ranger, which is a smaller ship, which goes out hunting for new boys to bring to Neverland to mine for Pixum, which is almost like fairy dust, which keeps people young, and keeps Blackbeard young. So he's very, and it's running out in Neverland, so he needs more people to dig deeper to get more Pixum, because he wants to stay young. So that's basically what it's about, and I've had a great time playing it, so I can't wait to see what it looks like.
And obviously, Mr. Hugh Jackman is our terrifying Captain Blackbeard. Can you talk about working with him? Because you guys have a lot of funny scenes together, it's fair.
Yeah. I mean, I remember, you know, a lot of great scenes that we played together. It was really great fun. A lot of people, you know, liked the kind of relationship that we had on set, and hopefully that comes across on camera. Hugh Jackman is an amazing actor. He's someone who's supremely generous and someone who is there not just to make his performance great, but he's there for the actors that he's working with. Always bringing gifts to set, always being positive. He's the first person there and the last person to leave. He's really an amazing, he's inspiring. I've learned a lot from him, actually. I think the thing about Levi is that even though he is a kid and he is enjoying his childhood and enjoying being on set and enjoying speaking to people and developing his character on set, but he's got a maturity about him that brings a certain level of quality to the role. And you don't find that often, especially in child actors. And he's done such a great job. It's been amazing.
Talking about great quality, obviously Joe Wright is a very accomplished director. What was it like working with him on this one?
Joe Wright was fantastic. Joe Wright, this is my I've known Joe for a long time. It's my second film with him, although, you know, there have been projects that we were hoping to work on, didn't work out, blah, blah, blah. But I've worked with Joe quite a few times, and I've known him since 2003. So it was great to just, it was like working with an old friend on set, you know? And he's a great guy, he's a visionary, and he's fastidious with every single little piece of every buttonhole, every button, everything on every costume and every set. He's got a piece in all of it. So it truly was directed by Joe Wright. I think the difference about this one is it's almost like a prequel to an earlier Peter Pan, to an earlier point in Pan's life that we haven't seen before in any other movie. In most movies, we concentrate on Hook being the bad guy. In this movie, this is before Hook becomes the bad guy. Almost Hook's his friend. So I think no one's seen this side of the story before, so I think it's going to be really interesting. I mean, I love fantasy, and as a kid, I used to play Dungeons and Dragons. I'm a Gen Con kind of geek. So for me, it's a dream come true to do anything that's fantasy and make-believe, because it's something that I used to envelop myself in as a child. So I'm really thrilled to be part of it.
Of course, on the subject of Thrones, fans were somewhat devastated to see more of the key cast members killed off, particularly Kit Harington. How do you feel about that, as someone who's been part of the show?
Well, I don't want to ruin it for everybody else that's seen it, but, you know, I don't know anything about what's going to happen next on Game of Thrones, and it is devastating to see that happen. But don't believe everything you see on Game of Thrones.